bébé c'est dolo. Awa wa rouzou wa ironda nous noa kodele. Awa funtole sou kode mandouna kouene. Boto vile kede wena ni hao matinto.
Ekoleya.
Oh ya wane. Ekoleya e. Oh ya wane. Ekoleya e.
Ekoleya.
Oh ya wane. Ekoleya e.
Oh.
Wulim la diva, diva ne la fa konna.
Ahum la singe, ahum la singe, ahum la singe, ahum la singe, ahum
la singe. Ahum kunye nye nye koko,
ahum
kunye nye nye agle. Nye 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 koko, huku nye 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 agle. Nye trovo, nye gane batrano, ngagle na, ngagle na.
beautiful, somebody with a good heart. I think that is beautiful. A lot of people don't have the strength to look inside somebody else's heart. That's really the only beauty there is in this world. What I see. Everything's lonely when I go to school. I leave early. It's all. I leave about 7 a.m. It's like usually a lot earlier than everybody else, so it's like all lonely outside.
I had a little friend right next door. The weirdest thing though, I only knew Spanish and she only knew English, but somehow we like always got along. And then one day she just moved away and gave me her pillow, and I have it ever since.
That apartment that we're living on, there, they said that it was too much gangsters, like on Bush and all the way to 14th Street and French.
There's like very few real people that I like pour my heart out to them, you know? And they know the way I am. Usually those people are like my family or my mother. She knows.
And he went like back to school just to play around in there, maybe basketball, I don't know. And I think there was a drive-by and they killed him. They confused him. And he was 14, 13 years old. He dressed like a gang member, but he wasn't.
Sometimes it takes a lot of courage to think about other people than yourself.
I have a best friend, and I know him like 6 years, but I'm trying to keep him away from gangs, but since his brother's a gangster, he probably wants to be a gangster too. Like, why do you like gangs and everything? And he always answered, because my brother's in it, I think like they're cool.
I wasn't like sure, but why not, you know? There wasn't anything better to look forward or do. So I did that, and I was like up for like 2 days. I cleaned up my house, I did laundry. I just felt great. I'm like, gee, this stuff is really great, you know? This is like better than counseling or something, you know?
I think it's right now that I got back to my dad. After that, I went to church with my mom. I think that's the happiest thing to happen.
You can kill persons or you can die of the gangster.
When you hear all of this, you think, oh, well, I guess that's what I am, you know, so you believe it. And you think that the only thing you have to do is be a gang member or get pregnant or whatever, you know?
Yeah, I may be Hispanic. Yeah, I may be just 17. And they might think I'm naive and this and that, but I think I'm worth a lot more than the credit that they would give me.
Thank you.
there's me, my mom, and Dania, and Rudy, and Rel, and my cousin and my uncle.
Though we fight and everything, we still have the good times, you know? We laugh and everything together and everything, you know? That's like the funny part about it.
She's actually kind of deaf, but now she has like a little hearing aid, so it's like really cool. When she can't hear us, we're like, pump up the volume, you know? So she's like, oh, you know, so she pumps it up and everything, you know, we're not screaming at each other.
My parents separated about 4 years ago, I think. Since then, my mom has been pretty much alone.
And be happy from all of the problems, and like not being fighting each other about this thing or that thing.
If I keep that along, I'm like going to repeat grade. Mama said, I don't want you to stay again right there. I want you to pass. I told my mom, I'm not going to tell you by words. You're going to see what I'm going to do.
She works every day. Every day she doesn't have no break. And okay, Fridays and Sundays she would work two houses. And for her to get like a free Sunday, it's like really rare. If my mom is happy, I am happy. That's the way it is, you know. My mom is sad, I'm sad. If she's crying, well then I'm crying.
sometimes I just get to thinking, I'm like, oh, why, you know, why have that extra pressure?
You get a lot of respect, a lot of power, you know, and usually a lot of people have respect for gang members, you know.
We were walking to the store, which is a block away. He was right there, so I talked to him for a little while. I'm like, hi, how you doing? We were like goofing around with each other a little, and then he's like, well, I gotta go, and I'm okay. And I go, but I'll see you later, right? And he's like, yeah.
Okay, I live in this neighborhood and there's gangs. I have to fit in, so I have to get in the gang. And there's really nothing else to do.
As I was walking into the store, I heard some shooting going on down the street. Then I walked into the store like nothing. I'm all, well, it's nothing, you know. Like always, it's never anything, you know.
Most of them don't live more than 21 years. Only the ones that quit live more. Like my cousin was only 19, and they shot him.
Sudden I look over to the side to where his mom's house was at, and I saw him there right on the doorstep. He had collapsed. I saw him there. He was all bleeding in the stomach and everything.
Suddenly I felt something sharp. I got out of control of the bike and fell. I couldn't do nothing. They were big. They were two. And I don't know. If I would do something, maybe I wouldn't be here right now.
Seven-year-old sister, I thought, you know, no, I can't take her over there. I have to take her home first. So the first thing I did was rush her home. And then when I rushed her home, my mom didn't let me out of the house anymore. She's like, no, I don't want you getting shot now.
Thank you.
in Mexico, so they could go further over there. And we had to go to ballet. So when we started doing Psalm 23, I started remembering of her and everything, you know. And it was really sad, and all that sadness, I just kind of like took it out and like in the dance and everything, you know. And it was like, that's why I think this year hasn't been so hard on me, because the dance was like a healer, and that's why I liked it so much. That's one of my goals, to get out of high school. So, you know, none of my family members have gone out of high school. Only two of them went, but they dropped out. You know, I just want to get out of high school, go to college, maybe go to university, you know?
All I want really is to be happy. That's all I want.
They ask you where you're from, who do you claim, which one is your radio, and if you say, they really ask me sometimes, where I'm from. I say I don't claim nothing. I just walk away.
I wanna be a doctor or a ballerina.
I'm hopes. Okay. First of all, I'm going to college next September. I'm already paying for it, so hopefully, if it ever happens, probably going to go to the University of the Arts and study some dance for a while. I'm mainly going to study a lot, though.
If I wasn't in ballet, I'm sure I would be right now in the game.
When I'm in a performance, I feel nervous, but then inside I feel really happy.
I hope to. I hope to find love within myself. That's what I hope from life, because sometimes I have a real hard time with that.
Right now, I'm gonna try. I'm not saying that. I'm gonna try. I'm gonna do it.
Thank you. Thank you.